So I have this philosophy of sliding roof, right? In stadiums, they're building US Open also, right? So when the fire comes, roof should close down. That was the job of the roof, right? When the nice weather comes, the roof opens up. So that's, I was the roof. That's, I tried to be that roof. I don't know whether I was always the roof, but I tried to be that roof. Anyone else? It's a very nice perspective. See, I never get to hear these, right? It's always like, complain and like, oh, how bad it is. It's good. I should leave more often.
I get to hear good stuff.
Anyone else?
What I feel is, I'm Indian from the blood. How we have grew up is making a mistake, getting beaten up by parents, and then being corrected.
Yeah.
So we made mistakes here, and why I felt it close, that I used to get beatings from you.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Gets a lot.
So those beatings, even though for a moment we don't like it, after certain days we always appreciate it. That's how we grew in India. Kids don't get beatings here, but in India they literally get beat.
I don't get beatings.
So that part is something I'll definitely miss.
Yeah, it's not beatings.
And I don't know, maybe it's just my bad luck that every time I join certain area where I'm seeing a great leader, I come in and the leader moves out. It happened when I joined Wipro. It happened when I came here, Jasmine moved out. And now it happened that I'm joining your team officially and you're moving out. So I don't know how maybe just my bad luck or something.
No, that means you're pushing the guy out.
No.
That is like you cannot handle, the ecosystem cannot handle.
But the chance to work with the leaders,
I think every transaction is worth cherishing. That's why I say live in the moment, right? Whatever 5 minutes, 10 minutes we get, you just live it, maximize it. You guys are so talented, right? So talented. Express yourself. He just expresses too much. So I don't know his expressions. But it's a gardener theory, right? So gardeners, how do they grow the flowers, right? They nurture. They put the right environment, but they also prune, right? So every year my plants, they get pruned. So next year, they come back with a better flower. So it's not weeding, it's pruning, I call it, because then only the flower can blossom. So once in a while, I do prune, and Robin gets pruned more than you guys, because he tries to blossom too fast. My deck is only small, right? You cannot go outside the deck. No, thank you, Robin, it means a lot. Anyone else?
Yeah, I'll speak for MSM team. That was your main team. And apart from what Arvind said, and definitely being a great leader, like, you did not restrict your mentoring to just Harper team. You have worked with Sharik, you have worked with me, you have worked with Sudan. Your mentoring was like irrespective of the team. You mentored the PMs, you mentored the team, then you mentored everybody to that extent that it's not like Harper, Wipro or anything. You considered every time your statement was, it's one family.
Right.
So with that intention, I think you took all the steps. And that's what, all the people who left, Sudan, Shari, myself, whoever worked with you, we appreciate that.
No, thank you. That means a lot. It is the family, right? It doesn't matter which hat we wear, Hartford, Wipro. We all come here to do the work. Hartford people also, they come here to do make living. You come here also to do make living. No one has any less, no one is more holier than anyone else. No one is any less holier. And as far as the mentoring is concerned, sharing perspectives, right?
Yeah.
You share perspectives, people learn. So you have to give credit to the people who adopt. Everyone has the same, it's like we have all have the same environment.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, some flowers, they grow the best. Some they don't, right? So the credit goes to you, Sudan, Sharik, team, that flower, not the environment. But yeah, that means a lot actually, that if you felt that, that makes me very satisfied as a person. Okay, anyone else before the Godfather speaks?
I'm not good at talking, so I just conclude it in 2 sentences. So no matter how busy you are, no matter what issues are running around, the moment when you see one of us, you will stop by your desk and you'll talk to us freely. You will share your stories, inspiring stories, funny stories. That is the best thing which I like in you. I mean, I don't want to talk about work stuff. So if you see a manager and if you see one of us, like no matter whether it's a developer or BA, you come to us first. You don't go to our manager first. You come to us first, talk to us.
Because he knows managers don't know anything.
Which is always good. Yeah, when there are some production issues, that is not good. We are the director, but...
Thank you. Yeah, that's true. Actually, laughing and we having that relationship, we just play different roles: manager, developer, director, client partner. We're just playing different roles, but we all are doing our job. And laughter is important. Kannan, that's why I was like very interested to hear it from Kannan, because Kannan, when we sat close in Simsbury,
yeah.
Oh, well, I had one of the best time of my life. So you walk out and Kannan has something going on. Right, and now, like, you know, I was just fortunate to meet with his wife also. So, you know, recently, we shared some great relationship and build relationships. Like, you think about the hours we spend at the work, right? You cannot consider it's like, oh, I just go to work, right? You spend so many hours. If you don't build relationships here, you're living a very void life, right? Then you go home, you're tired, you only have wife or your child, and then you get on the call in the night again. So let's make it meaningful. Okay, one more. Okay, sorry,
there are more.
Just few words. We are one of the leaders who is emotionally and intellectually connected to the team, so that the team learns, not only the layer which is very close to the management, even, you know, everyone. So I would like to thank for that, and you know, we'll be looking forward to seeing an early leader.
Thank you. He also gets my love a lot. Robin and Surya are the special ones. No, thank you, Surya. That's very nicely put. Very well articulated. Anyone else?
Yeah, any? Just one point here. Like, personally, I feel the fitness thing that you stress on has really helped me.
I wish Sudan was here today.
Sudan still owes me $600 for not losing that much weight.
Yeah,
it's a well-being, overall well-being, right? Staying fit, staying healthy, then only you can do the job. It's not like, you know, that's the whole purpose, isn't we inspire each other, right? There's nothing bad in, so thank you, at least, a lot of people actually, me too. Stan was a great influence on me. Stan was a very hardcore, I stopped eating burgers and the fries and the Diet Cokes. And so yeah, we all have different influences. So yeah, I didn't think of that aspect at all. Thank you, Mohit.
Okay, let me speak as well. Let me talk here and then present the team a little bit. Okay.
So
yeah, then speak
camera
quiet.
Also.
That's the camera on here, and not on me.
Camera and the So last 2 years, I think it has been a great journey for Wipro working in the MSM area and overall in the personal lines here. As we wind up our journey in the MSM space and move towards more invest focus, we see that in the MSM, working with you and specifically a lot of leaders like technical leaders like Brian and other people who are there in this area, whole the culture in MSM is such that the team has been able to groom themselves. They have come as developers, senior developers, tech leads, but they have become a better human being. They have been able to deal with the stress. They have been able to laugh at work. They have been able to be a team player. And those learnings are immense for many of my team members who has come and expressed, like actually today Jasmine is not there here. He is working in India. He has been working in this area and he remembers all those stories. He narrates those stories. Then I have Ram here, he comes back frequently to me and narrates those stories. Surya was talking about it. Many of those, my team members, who has that attachment and that confidence and that fearlessness, where when something is being told, right, they will, whatsoever they are working on, that will be protected. That is a great asset for anyone and for any leaders, where you can blindly trust, that is a great thing.
for me, that is has been the biggest learning from working with you, Satendra, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you. I don't want to cry, but thank you. That was an Oscar speech. Thank you. That means a lot that people feel that. And I hope you can. There are great leaders here. You also, you know, you have tasted a nice wine if you drink or, you know, good food. Make sure that you share that with others and also demand for it. There's no reason not to demand for it. And also give to others also if you see anything. That's what I would ask, Manish. Thank you.
Okay, so it's a little difficult for me to, you know, talk about Satyendra because he is one of those guys, many of you know, all of you talked about, you know, it's very difficult to be a leader and give credit to others, especially to a vendor, you know, staff. That is something you have to be ultra confident about yourself. You have to know what you are, where you are, to be able to let go of that and, you know, give credit to others. This is something, you know, I don't know any of you have seen a video of Abdul Kalam. Abdul Kalam had, you know, talked about exactly this. In his formative years, he's saying his boss, when he was, you know, heading ISRO, one of his first project where they were sending a, you know, spaceship out, you know, it went up, it failed, crashed miserably. So, you know, his boss came and said, you know, okay, everyone is sitting with a glum face. Who is going to go and, you know, meet the press and, you know, explain this out? He said, you know, okay, I will. And he went and he sat. And these guys were all standing behind. Abdul Kalam was standing behind this guy. He took the blame. He said, yes, we tried. It failed. But we will do it again in what he gave a, you know, time period, you know, 6 months or 1 year or something. We will be back again and we will succeed. We'll learn from our mistakes and we'll come back. So, of course, he took a lot of brickbats. There's a lot of, you know, the usual stuff. 6 months or that one year period, he said, after that they send the thing again and it was a success. So then again the press meet. So he said, you know, hey, come, you know, let's do the press meet. He said, no, you go back, you go back. So that shows, because he said, now it's success. He led the team ahead. And that is something which I have seen in Satyendra personally. He's a very emotional guy, right? He will scold you, as you were saying, you know, scold you, you know, he will mentor you, tutor you. But that, you know, it's like polishing a diamond. You know, he will hone you. So if you go through that process, what happens is you come out as a better human being, as a better professional. So that is something which very few people take the time or the energy to do that, to give you that feedback, that insights. Satyendra, he does that. And why he does that, why he's able to do that is, you know, because he's intellectually at a level where he knows that, you know, you are not going to be a threat to him. At the core, that is where it comes and stands. So that is the first part. Second part, you know, now I'll talk, you know, from where I, you know, interacted with him and, you know, my personal relationship where, or, you know, not the relationship alone, that of course has always been there, but where my admiration for him came from. That is about 3 to 4 years back when, you know, Vipro was signing or, you know, we got in that, he mentioned about Trisha McKechnie. When under Trisha's regime, when we were about to get the managed services. So we started talking with Satyendra, and our team was talking with Satyendra and Stan, of course, but Satyendra now is the tech lead for that whole thing about the widget-based model. And Satyendra's, you know, insights and, you know, his, you know, financial acumen is something I really, really appreciated and, you know, respected at that time. The way he could understand, because that is a new model, no one had done it, even Vipro had not done it. I'm not talking about managed services. Everyone has done managed services. Outsourcing, no big deal. All of us have done it. But that widget-based model, the way, you know, we came up with that and the way it was discussed, because he was leading it from the Hartford side. And the way we discussed it, you know, a lot of discussions to and fro. But that is where, you know, I realized I saw him in action and saw his financial equipment, his understanding, his grasp of situations, and his understanding of, you know, the person sitting on the other side of the table. You know, and his respect for that. That is something which I really, where he earned my kudos. You know, I respected him from that day. And of course, then things settled down. You know, we went through the things. And, you know, as you guys talked about, what he has done, it's, you know, it's something which, and I personally really, really feel, it's something which any leader should, you know, and especially when you're sitting on the other side of the table, that means, you know, you are in the buy position, you know, not in the sell position. We are all in the sell positions. he is in the buy position because he represents the customer. When you're in a buy position, to take time, energy to, you know, mentor.